Hi friends, welcome to Princess of Tech. This is Lakshmi Saroja. In the earlier videos, we had discussed about introduction of SQL, DBMS and its types, summary of SQL. In this video, I will explain you about installation and how to run queries on mobile. The DBMS that we are learning is RDBMS. The DBMS that we are using is Oracle or Oracle DB. If you install Oracle database software, you get two inbuilt tables. They are EMP table, which is nothing but employee table, DEPT table, which is nothing but department table. These two tables we have inbuilt. DQL language is used for searching the data in the database. The complete DQL language we will searching in the EMP and DEPT tables. You may have a doubt, why we use only these two inbuilt tables, why we can't create our own tables and search the data as per our requirements? The answer for the question is, with 0% knowledge, if we create a table and searching in it, it is a bit complex. So we are using inbuilt tables. Oracle DB is not an open source software. It means we can't download it from Google. It is a licensed software. So instead of that, we are running those queries in the mobile applications, which is available in our Google Play Store. The name of the app is MySQL Mobile Developer. Go to Play Store and in search option, type MySQL Mobile Developer. The logo of the app is visible like this, as shown in the video. Install it and after installation, click on Open. The interface of the app looks like this. Click on Demo Schema and then click on SQL Sheets. You can write a query here as shown in the video, and after writing query, click on run option. You get output. I want to display complete EMP table as output, so I will write a query according to it. Select star from EMP, semicolon. Semicolon is mandatory here. Here star indicates the complete information of an employee from employee table. If my query is correct, then I will get an output of 14 rows. See, I got 15 rows. In the app, it displays one duplicate record, which are observed here. Smith is displayed twice. In Oracle, we get 14 rows. EMP table contains EMP number, ename, job, MZR, hire date, SELSR, CVMM, and DEPT number of an employee. My question is, how to display the total information in the department table? Come, let's write a query. Select star from DEPT. Here star means we want complete information. From which table DEPT? See, it displays 4 rows. The DEPT table contains DEPT NO, DNAME and location. Now let me explain you what is the EMP table, DEPT table and their columns. The table name is EMP. We again also call it as employees table. Inside EMP, what's the first column? EMP NO. It means employee number. ename is called as employee name. Now tell me, what is the employee name of 7566? Jones, right? 7566 belongs to an employee called as Jones. After ename, next column is job. Job is also called as designation. Now what is the designation of king? President, right? The next column is MZR. It means manager employee number. You have doubt, what is this manager employee number? For every employee working in a company, they must work under a manager. Now see in the table, Smith is working under which manager? The MZR number is 7902. Then we have to search in the EMP number. 7902. If MZR number equal to EMP number, then he is the manager of Smith. Here, fourth manager of Smith. Hire date is also known as joining date. On which date those employees have joined in the company? Sal is nothing but salary. See here, the data present in the table is monthly or yearly. It is monthly salary, but they are created according to the dollars. The next one, COMM, is known as commission. Here we can find empty spaces. It is called null data. Here we can, in the mobile we get null data. In the Oracle DB, it represents spaces. Here 0 is different, null data is different. DBT number is known as department number. Every employee working in some department, no? This department is nothing but department number. The next table is DEPT number. Inside DEPT, the first column is DEPT NO is DEPT number. D name means department number. Location, LOC means location of the department. Now let's tell me what is the department name of department number 20. It is research. Likewise, we will write our queries to retrieve the data in the database. EMP table consists of following columns. EMP NO, it means employee number. E name, employee name. Job designation, MGR. Manager employee number. Hire date, joining date. SAL, it means salary. COMM, commission. DEPT number, department number. The department table consists of following columns. DEPT NO, department number. D name, department name. LOC, location. Come, let's write some queries according to our requirements of retrieving the data from the respective tables. Question: write a query to display employee names of all the employees. Here we want only names of the employees. So select ename from EMP. So it displays the only names of an employees. See the output. The next question: write a query to display salaries of all the employees. Here they want only salaries. Nothing will be wanted. Select SAL sal from EMP semicolon. Then it displays only salaries of the employees. Next question: write a query to display department names of all the departments. Select DNAME from DEPT. It displays department names in all the departments. Next question: write a query to display location of all the departments. It only want locations. Locations we can find in which table? DEPT table. So select location from DEPT. It gives only locations. See the output. Next question: write a query to display joining date of all the employees. Joining date, as we discussed earlier, it is nothing but hire date. Select hire date from EMP semicolon. Click on run option, we will get the output. Next question: write a query to display department number of all the employees. It only want department number from the employees, so we have to fetch it in employee table. Select DEPT number from EMP semicolon. Next question: write a query to display employee names and salaries of all the employees. Here we want two as outputs. One is enames and salaries. So select ename comma sal from EMP. So it displays employee names along with salaries. See the output. Next we will discuss some important questions like which we asked frequently in the interviews. Write a query to display department name and its location for all the departments. Here we want department names along with locations. Department name and locations we can find in department table. So select DNAME comma location from DEPT semicolon. Here we get DNAME and locations of the department table. Next question: query to display name, salary, commission and joining date of every employee. Here we want ename, sal, commission and hire date. We want four things. So select space ename comma sal comma commission comma hire date from EMP. So then we get all these things as output. Next question: write a query to display employee name, his designation and his manager employee number. Here we want, see, designation means job, manager employee number means MGR. So write a query, select space ename comma job comma MGR space from space which table? EMP. So EMP semicolon. Then we get all these things as output: ename, job and MGR, manager employee number as output. Next question is: Write a query to display all the details of each and every employee of the company. Each and every employee where we find in the employee table. So here indirectly it explains all it. It is going to be display all the information. So here we give have to give star. Select star from EMP semicolon. See, it displays all the employee tables information. If we scroll to right, then we find all the information because mobile screen is too low. Next question. Write a query to display all the details of the department present in a company. All the department means it's present in department table. It want all the information. It means D name, D number and location. Department number, department name and location. So select star from DEPT. It displays location, D name and department number as shown in the figure. See you soon with next upcoming videos.